Well, Sally, old girl, it's finally happened. After all the years of taking the insults and being accused of God knows what and the public humiliation that you have been taking from that family, it has finally happened. You finally got hold of something where you can fight back and even the score a little bit. My daughter Macy and I will no longer have to be a doormat for the likes of Stephanie Forrester and the rest of that upper crust bunch of...
You're scum, you know that. And I detest you.
Well, frankly, Stephanie, I think I was losing my edge if you didn't.
You live in the gutter, Sally. That's why you can't get any lower than you already are.
In other words, I'm taking a leaf from your book.
Slander?
What slander? This is news, Stephanie. The public wants to know. The public has a right to know what the rich and mighty Forresters get up to when they're not being photographed at charity events.
I wouldn't do this to your family, no matter how angry or justified I might feel.
Well, maybe that's because you'd never have any reason to do it. Because I have never done to your family what you have done to mine.
I haven't done anything to your family.
Haven't you? Huh. Oh, wait a minute. That's well put. Yeah. That says it all. Nothing is what you have done. How many times have you invited your daughter-in-law, Macy, over to your home for a quiet little chat, a cup of tea, maybe a family dinner? How many times have you ever reached out to that girl when she was doing everything she could to please you and welcomed her as an addition to your family? Have you done that even once since she and Thorne got married? No, Stephanie. You have given her the same treatment you have always given me, and that is the ice-cold shoulder and a one-way ticket back to the gutter where you think we belong. So, now the shoe is on the other foot. And what is so wrong if we finally have a chance to look down on you for a change? This story about Brooke Forrester's baby and the question about who the father is too good to bury. All the smart money in town is already laying bets that if Eric Forrester isn't the father, then it has to be his son, Ridge. Okay. Now let's see how the public reacts when they get the news. And let's see how you react. Let's see how you stand up to what is going to be coming your way. All the slander and the bum jokes and the innuendo and the public humiliation and that awful, helpless feeling you're going to have, the one I've had for years. You get ready for it because you are going to have that feeling, lady. Oh, are you going to feel it? Do you know how long I have waited for this moment, Stephanie? I have finally got you exactly where I want you.
And exactly where is that?
Right where you and the rest of that hypocritical Forrester clan are finally going to get your comeuppance.
Why are you doing this?
I like watching you squirm.
Don't flatter yourself, Sally.
Oh, I wouldn't. Listen, after all of the cheap shots you've taken at me and my family in public, after all of the pain and misery you and Thorne and the rest of the Forresters have brought to my daughter Macy, I think it's only simple justice that the press tear you to shreds for a change. Oh, boy, can't you just see those headlines, huh, Stephanie? Forrester sex scandal. Designer's wife bears stepson's baby.
There isn't any truth to this.
Yeah, but there could be, though, couldn't there? Especially since Brooke Forrester herself isn't any too sure about who that baby's father is.
Don't you go around concocting fantasies about my family.
I haven't concocted anything. I read it right on Brooke's medical chart.
What the hell were you doing in her hospital room?
I don't think that matters, does it, Stephanie? The facts are these. They have asked for a paternity test on Brooke's baby. Now, there's no way that you can deny that, Stephanie. No way at all.
There isn't anything here to deny.
Not even to preserve your precious reputation?
There isn't anything I have to preserve about my reputation. It's your reputation that's in danger.
Really? I'm going to be a hero.
You're going to be the laughingstock of the town.
For what? Airing a little dirty laundry? Maybe exposing a few sordid bits of the holier-than-thou Forrester dynasty?
For lying.
You wish I was lying.
Do you really think that if there was a question of paternity, that would be written in a hospital chart for the staff, for the whole world to see?
I don't know. I only know what I saw with my own two eyes.
Did you happen, while you were browsing through that, to notice comments about jaundice?
Jaundice? What's that got to do with anything?
Well, you do know what jaundice is, don't you?
Sure. Jaundice is something that is common in some newborn babies.
Yes. Most of the time, it's nothing serious. Other times, it can be an indication of incompatibility with the baby's blood and the parent's blood.
So what?
Well, that's what they're testing. They're testing the compatibility of the baby's blood with its parents.
That isn't what it said on the chart.
What did it say?
It said genetics blood test, paternity panel.
Paternity panel? That's exactly what it is. They're checking Eric's blood with the baby. That's all there is to this, Sally.
Oh, come on, Stephanie. You don't really expect me to buy that, do you? I can assure you that the ladies and gentlemen of the press are not going to buy into this jaundice smokescreen story any more than I am.
I don't care whether you buy this or you don't. It's the truth. But I do want you to leave my family alone.
Why should I believe you?
Don't. You know, maybe the best thing is just to let you run around town flapping your lips about this fantasy. The press knows a cheap shot when they see it, Sally. Why do you think Randy extended me the courtesy of coming to the office to verify this first?
He's a professional journalist. Checking his facts is part of his job.
No. He doesn't trust you. No one in town trusts you. You're not trustworthy.
Now, wait a minute.
No, you wait a minute. What about Macy?
Macy?
Yes.
What's she got to do with it?
Do you think that the press wouldn't look and see exactly what's going on here? They know about Thorne and Macy. Do you really want to accept the responsibility of some sort of salacious press concerning your own daughter?
Hey, I didn't make this up.
No, but you didn't get your facts straight. And don't you start tossing innuendos around about my family without getting your facts straight, Missy.
Sally, I need your signature on it.
Hello, Jack.
Stephanie, how are you?
Fine, thank you. And you?
Fine.
Excuse me, I don't want to break up this tete-a-tete.
What are you doing here?
Stephanie and I were just wrapping up a meeting, Jack.
Excuse me, a meeting?
Yeah, kind of an unscheduled meeting, you know.
I'm sorry, this...
It doesn't concern you.
Sally?
She's right, Jack. It doesn't concern you. I mean, we weren't comparing notes on you or anything.
Oh, are you seeing Sally again?
Yes.
Look, I think it'd be better if I left you two alone so you could have a little talk.
No, thank you, Sally. There really isn't anything to discuss.
Stephanie.
You know, it really doesn't matter to me. It's of no consequence who you choose to see, no matter how obnoxious the choice.
Now, what the hell does that mean?
It means it doesn't come as a surprise. The two of you have a lot in common. You're both untrustworthy.
Stephanie, wait.